Welcome to another video. Today we will be talking about configuring external shares in your Nextcloud server. So you've installed your Nextcloud and you followed my tutorials to do some little configurations and get it up and running. And now you're wondering, well, how can I add external shares? Because for me, I didn't want to save my files on my Nextcloud virtual machine because anything can happen. So I wanted an external file or external share that I can attach to my Nextcloud and still be able to access my files remotely. So in order for us to do this, we need to install the external share application. So for you to do this, you want to log in as administrator as always, and then you want to go into the administrative settings. Actually, you want to go into the application settings for now. We'll leave administrative settings. So you want to go to apps. And once you get into apps, you want to search and look for external shares. Oops, I'm going to go back to application here. Sorry. I clicked too fast. Okay. So external storage support. Once you are here, all you need to do is download and enable the app. I already have the app downloaded and enabled. So once you download that app and you enable it, now we want to go into administrative settings. And then we're going to go down to external storage support. And now you can see we have the option to mount an external storage. Nextcloud in its own supports Amazon S3 storage. It supports FTP, local, Nextcloud, OpenStack. So Nextcloud, if you want to connect another Nextcloud server's storage to your Nextcloud. OpenStack object storage, SFTP, which is the secure version of FTP. I won't advise anyone to use FTP anymore. Unless you really don't have a choice, then web dev. So if you notice in here, we don't have SMB. Well, how do we get SMB? What we need to do is install the SMB client for us to be able to get SMB. So in order for us to do this, we're going to head over to our command line as always. And once we are here, we need to install the PHP SMB client that is needed. For us to do that, we're going to run the command sudo apt install smb client. So once you do that, your Ubuntu system is going to go ahead and install the smb client that is needed for Nextcloud. So this may take some time depending on the speed of your virtual machine. I'm actually running this currently on Raspberry Pi, so it's taking a sweet time. And once that's complete, we are going to restart Apache just to make sure that the settings are all in line. And now we will go ahead back to the GUI and do the configuration that we need to. So now that the installation is complete, I'm going to go ahead and run my restart for Apache. Yep, once again, I spelled that wrong. I can't type correctly. Okay, that's done. We're going to go back to our user interface. We'll refresh the page. And if we go now to add storage, we can see here we have SMB/CIFS. Now we can go ahead to the next part of the video, which is actually testing that the SMB works by creating or adding an SMB storage to our Nextcloud server. So now that we have our SMB client installed, what we're going to do is mount an SMB share. So in order for us to be able to mount an SMB share, we have to go into our external storage in administration, and we're going to select the storage option for SMB. So when you do that, you want to give your folder a friendly name. this is the folder, or this is the name of the folder that's going to be displayed in Nextcloud. So in this case, we're just going to call it Git Together. And then we're going to move to authentication. So for authentication, you have different types. You can either use the username and password, which means you're going to enter a username and password as part of the configuration. You can use login credentials. Login credentials be it when a user logs into your Nextcloud. Nextcloud can save the login information or credentials either in this while in this session, or you can save it in the Nextcloud MySQL database. And when a user needs to access a share like SMB, it's going to then pass those credentials for authentication. You can also use global credentials, which you can enter those credentials down here and save them. So every time you mount a share, you just need to select global credentials and it's going to automatically use those global credentials. And then you can use Kerberos tickets or Kerberos tickets for Apache mode. But for this video, we're just going to use username and password, because that's what most of you out there are going to use, username and password. So the next thing we want to enter the configuration setting. So we're going to enter the host name or the IP address of your share file servers. So in this case, if you're using a NAS like I am, I'm using a NAS at my home. I'm using True NAS. So that's the IP address of my True NAS server. Then you enter the name of the share file. So this is the name of the file that you're sharing or that you've shared. So in this case, I created a share file in my True NAS and I called it Git Together. And if you wanted to share a remote subfolder, so a specific subfolder in that file and not the whole folder, what you can do is we can do that and then we can specify a folder. So let's say if in our share file, which is I'm going to open it here, Git Together, if I create a new folder in here and call it test, if we wanted to share, so let's say I have two folders, test and man. If you wanted to share test and not man, so in here, you will specify the subfolder test, okay? We're just going to see how that works. So we want to share just test, and we don't want to share everything in the folder. So for domain, if you have a domain name, you're going to enter your domain name. Domain name mainly because if your share folder or your NAS, if your NAS authenticates using Active Directory, so you want to put the domain suffix in there, because you know with Active Directory users log in with the domain suffix slash the username. So I am authenticating with my NAS using a domain, so Active Directory domain, so I enter the domain name. If it's not the same for you, then you don't have to worry about it. Just leave that blank and then you enter the username and now you enter the password. So you can select the show hidden files for Nextcloud to show hidden files if files are hidden in those folders. Or you can also select the option to verify ACL access when listing files. This way, Nextcloud is only going to list files that the user that we have entered here has permissions to access. So if in that test subfolder there are three files on there and two are owned by someone else that this user account doesn't have access, then Nextcloud is not going to display them. So then we're just going to select all users because we want all of our users to be able to access that folder, or you can select in here and select specific users or groups, but I have just one group, so that's why you see just one group and one user. So I want all users, and then I'll press the tick. As you can see, I get a green check mark, which means everything is good, it was successfully mounted. If I mistyped something on here and try it again, you're gonna see we'll get an error. So everything is good, we'll save that. And we'll go back to our files, and now if we open that, you can see it is empty because Nextcloud is only accessing the test folder. So I can make another folder in here and call it test one. And if we go back and refresh, as you can see, that is automatically populated into our Nextcloud server. So if I go back to administrative settings and I go to external storage, I can also go ahead right now and remove the subfolder and share the whole amount, the whole folder that I created for Nextcloud, SMB folder. So if I go back to files, now if we open Geek together, gonna have to refresh. If we open Geek together now, you can see we have access to all the folders, the test folder and the man folder. Also, the permissions, how the permissions work for the share folders are, the user that you use to create or to mount the share, the permissions are then passed along onto your Nextcloud server. So if this user has permissions to create folders or add files and delete files in that SMB share, then yes, everyone who has access to this file share that we've added into Nextcloud will be able to create and delete folders and files on our share. That is the downside to using the username and password. Everyone has the access of the user that mounts the share. But if you were to use the login credentials, save in session, or save in database, then now your users on your Nextcloud are going to have different permissions. So if a user, John, logs in and he only has permissions to delete and create folders, that's all he's going to have. If another user, Mary, logs in and Mary only has permissions to upload files or create files in that share but cannot delete, that's the permission they're going to have. So in this case, we're just making it simple. Everyone has the same permissions to our mounted SMB share. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, please leave it down in the comment section below. Please do not forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel.